You look out on this field, I know it brings back great memories of 2005. You won 15 games here. You were the best pitcher in the country, and you take your team to the World Series. That season really had to help you mature as a pitcher and get you to the big leagues, didn't it?
I think that year was a very, very big stepping stone for me in my career. The coaching that I had here at Tennessee, but also the teammates that I had around me. You know, I mean, I had guys, you know, that wanted to be great as well. And when you surround yourself with a bunch of winners, a bunch of guys that, you know, are hard workers, a bunch of guys that want to win a national championship, it only makes you better. And so that year really was a big stepping stone for me. You know, that's what we set out to do is we had one goal in mind, and that was to get to Omaha. And, you know, taking that type of a mentality to the pro ball level, you know, a lot of that doesn't happen that much, you know, especially in the minor league system. You know, guys are trying to just get to the next level. But then at the big league level, it becomes that again. And so having that experience, you know, of being on a winning team, of being on a team that's sold out to one goal and one goal only, you know, will only help and can only help.
What made you such a good pitcher that year? Did you develop another pitch, or did you just learn how to pitch that year?
You know, I just think that I realized that, you know, to be a good pitcher, you got to make good pitches. It wasn't anything mechanical. It wasn't anything, you know, a new pitch.
No magic wand.
It was just, you know, I just focused on making good pitches, and you know, that's how the game works. And you know, the game can get complicated. There's a lot of experts out there that say you got to do this to be good, or you got to do this to be good. But it comes down to, you know, you make good pitches and you're good. You make bad pitches and you're not good. It's almost that simple. And from a pitching standpoint, sometimes having that mentality can be tough. But my junior year, I feel like I realized that, and that's all that I was worried about.
Can you talk about the regionals and when you finally you win that one game that's so special in the regional finals, and now you know you're going to Omaha. What do you remember about that game?
Really, all that I remember about that game was a dog pile. That is, you know, it's like, I mean, it's one of the greatest feelings that I've ever had on a baseball field. You know, winning that last game to go to Omaha and everything that we'd worked for, you know, the past 3 years, and just, you know, killing ourselves at 6 a.m. in the weight room, or, you know, early morning runs, you know, working hard at practice, all that stuff just paying off. It was just like, it was so worth it. It was so worth it just to be in the bottom of that dog pile.
And I guess now pitching in Kansas City, the World Series is special to those people in that part of the country. And so that's always on your resume that you pitched at Tennessee, you pitched for the Kansas City Royals, and you went to the College World Series. That's special for those folks in the Midwest, isn't it?
No doubt about it. I mean, College World Series is really, really big out there. I mean, Omaha's, you know, 3 hours from Kansas City, and so those people love the College World Series. And when I was in AAA playing in Omaha, there's a lot of people from Omaha that, oh, I remember 2005, you know, and you know, that that brings back a lot of good memories.